Hi, I'm Steve Carstensen. Here's a fundamentals of sleep apnea quick tip for you. Sleep apnea comes when the airway closes behind your tongue. So this little quick graphic shows you no obstruction when air is flowing well. It shows you when airway starts to narrow and you can see a flattening of flow, which means if you think about how the lungs can fill with air, then it can flow in and it can only flow in so much. And as the airway narrows more and more, less and less air can flow in. When you're squeezing a lungs full of air through too small of a space, then that can vibrate and that's called snoring. If it closes off completely, we have sleep apnea. And when you have a sleep apnea event, that triggers a lot of body response that ends up with a disruption in sleep that can tell your patients that they're in trouble by giving them a bad night's sleep. They'll feel that. Their bed partners can record these episodes where they're not breathing. Snoring is certainly an issue for lots of people. And there's body problems around the whole physiology based on just this change in airflow. So looking at the graph here, we have no obstruction, we have reduced flow, more and more work by the body, and we have a complete closure of the airway called obstructive sleep apnea. Very handy to use a chart like this to illustrate this to your patients about what's going on and to train your team so everybody on the team can know about how sleep apnea can affect the body.